Rock and Roll Jeopardy! And here is our host, Jeff Probst!
Hey everybody, and welcome to Rock and Roll Jeopardy, where good news always sleeps till noon. Pretty simple game. This is a musical version of Jeopardy. Everything about this game, everything to do with the show, is about rock and roll. Right next to me, literally a den of thieves just dying to get their mitts on our board. Loretta, if you will, introduce us.
Be glad to, Jeff. First, we have a chemical engineer and disc jockey from Lakewood, California, Douglas Leon. Next, we have a public information officer, originally from Long Island, New York, Randi Joseph. And finally, we have a student and instructor, originally from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Alex Gould.
Guys, glad to have you here. It's, you know how to play. You're playing for points. Player with the most points at the end of the game. Douglas, what happens?
You win.
$5,000.
$5,000.
That's what you need to know. You guys ready to go?
Absolutely.
Let's light up the board. Here's what I can tell you about this. You have one daily double in this round, and everything needs to be what? In the form of a question? Alex?
Absolutely.
Just making sure you're with me. Let's check out the categories. Singers who act. Billy Joel, Grammy's Best New Artist, rock nicknames, musical numbers, and words in common. Two things. Words in common, that will be titles that share a word, and the Grammy's Best New Artist, we will give you the year, and we'll play you the song, and then you give us the artist. You got all that? Who won the coin toss?
I did.
I think it was you. Randi, start us off.
I will take Billy Joel for 100, please.
All right. Billy met her in the Caribbean in 1983 and married her in New York Harbor in 1985. The marriage sank in 1994. Randi.
Who is Christie Brinkley?
You're right.
I'll stay with Billy Joel for 200, please.
His lounge act in 1972 inspired this, his first solo top 40 hit. Alex.
What is the Piano Man?
Piano Man is right.
Billy Joel for 300.
Okay. In 1998, Billy toured with this man who is two entries away from him in Billboard top 40 hits. Alex.
Who is Elton John?
Elton John is right.
Billy Joel for 400.
Why not? In 1990, kids at an elementary school in Wisconsin used this Joel hit to study history. Randi.
What is We Didn't Start the Fire?
Correct.
I will take Billy Joel for 500, please.
Round it out. It's such a lonely word. Randi.
What is honesty?
Honesty is right.
Great. I'll take Singers Who Act for 100, please.
Knock on Mahogany, she starred in Lady Sings the Blues. Randi.
Who is Diana Ross?
Diana Ross.
I will take Singers Who Act for 200, please.
You can have it. This policeman was in 1979's Quadrophenia. Randi.
Who is Sting?
Off to a running start.
Stay in the same category for 300, please.
You may not remember him in the Linguini incident, but you should in The Man Who Fell to Earth. Randi.
Who is David Bowie?
David Bowie.
Same category, 400, please.
Cher didn't have to share an Oscar for this 1987 film. Randi.
What is Moonstruck?
Right.
And I will take Singers Who Act for 500, please.
You big hog. In 1998, this country singer starred with Patrick Swayze in Black Dog. Douglas.
Who is Randi Travis?
Welcome to the game.
Thank you. Can I work a comment for 100, please?
All night, blank, tall Sally. Randi.
What is long?
Long.
I'll take words in common for 200, please.
One way or blank, brick in the wall. Randi.
What is another?
Another is right.
Words in common for 300, please.
Cruel to be blank of a drag. Douglas.
Cruel to be kind. What is kind?
Correct.
Words in common, 400, please.
Handy blank on the moon. Randi.
What is man?
Man is right.
I'll take words in common for 500, please.
Okay. To love, blank, to love. Alex.
What is someone?
Nope. Douglas?
Who is someone?
No. Who is somebody? I know. Alex, it's yours.
I'll take musical numbers for 100.
A Prince song says, "So tonight I'm gonna party like it's this." Randi.
What is 1999?
Right.
Musical numbers for 200, please.
In this Matchbox 20 song, she only sleeps when it's raining. Randi.
What is 3 a.m.?
3 a.m. is right.
Musical numbers for 300, please.
Mariah Carey and Boyz II Men sang this song together. Alex.
What is One Sweet Day?
Right.
Okay, musical numbers for 400.
It's an audio clue. It's the number one hit heard here. Alex.
What is Two Become One?
Two Become One, correct. The Spice Girls.
Musical numbers for 500.
Sammy Hagar saying, write me up for 125, take my license because of this inability. Douglas.
What is can't drive 55?
Correct.
Can I get rock nicknames for 100, please?
All right, for 100, the king. Randi?
Who is Elvis Presley?
Elvis is right.
Rock nicknames for 200, please.
For 200, the king of pop. Alex.
Who is Michael Jackson?
Correct.
Rock nicknames for 300.
For 300, we have the godfather of soul. Douglas.
Who is James Brown?
James Brown.
Can I get rock nicknames for 400, please?
Try this one on. Lizard King. Douglas.
Who is Jim Morrison?
Nice.
Can I get rock nicknames for 500, please?
You sure can. The Killer. Douglas.
Who is Jerry Lee Lewis?
You got it.
Can I get Grammy's Best New Artist for 100, please?
All right. These are all audio clues. Remember, we'll tell you the year. We'll play you the song. You give us the artist. Here it is. 1981. Alex.
Who is Sheena Easton?
Sheena Easton, right. Morning Train.
Best New Artist for 200.
200. The year was 1983. Douglas.
Who is Culture Club?
Culture Club. Boy George, yes.
Can I get Grammy's Best New Artist for 300, please?
Sure. How about 1965? Randi.
Who is Tom Jones?
Tom Jones. It's not unusual.
400, please.
Okay. The Daily Double. All right, now before we get to the Daily Double, we have a little business to take care of. Alex and Douglas, under the category Words in Common for 500, your guess of someone instead of somebody, which is what we were looking for, is also correct. So we're going to change the scores accordingly, cool. Give you guys your points.
Yeah. Thank you.
We'll take care of that. There we go. Now, Randi, let's catch up the scores before you make your wager. 3,400, Douglas at 2,700, and Alex at 2,000. It's a new game. What do you want to wager?
I'll wager 1,200.
1,200. All right, the year is... 1992.
That's his name. No one ever knew his name because he's a no one. Never thought twice about spending on and over him until I had the chance to really get to know one. Now that I know him, to give him money is a chair.
Who is Arrested Development?
Nice job, Mr. Wendell.
Whoa.
Let's close out this board. Grammy's Best New Artist. The year was 1979.
Well,
anybody? Wow. Who is Ricky Lee Jones? Chucky's in love. Chucky's in. All right, that's it for Jeopardy. Let's take a look at the scores. Randi, 4,600. Douglas, 2,700. Alex, 2,000. Very tight game. We'll take a quick break. Come back and meet these Yahoos right after this. Jeopardy, let's meet the players. Douglas Leon, a chemical engineer.
Yes, sir.
With a pierced tongue. Let me get a look at that. That's pretty decent.
Thank you.
Now, do your peers, you come into work, you got a little sulfur and...
I don't know, but my parents know about it now.
Oh, do they?
Oh. Thank you very much.
Like that could be a secret?
Yeah, that's true, too.
All right, so it says here you like to sneak around. You got backstage once by posing.
As a photographer for the Romantics concert, I wanted to get back to meet the band, so I got all my photo equipment out. And I went back and just told them I'm with the Chicago Tribune. And they said, okay, and let me through.
You know, there, just in the 20 seconds we've talked, there's a theme in your life. You're living a lie.
Oh, yeah.
Your parents don't know about this. You pretend to be a... All right. Well, you're playing very well today. Nice to have you here. Randi Joseph from Long Island, a public information officer. You had a DJ business.
My husband and I had a DJ business for 10 years and lots of kids and... We're done now.
It got to be too much?
We're done now, yeah.
What was it, the things the kids were doing? What was happening?
Well, we play games with the kids. My least favorite game, which the kids loved, we'd fill their mouths with marshmallows and make them say chubby bunny until they couldn't say it anymore, and I ruined a lot of good cocktail dresses that way.
Kids humor. You just can't beat it.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you are actually in the lead, so you're doing very well. Alex Gould, originally from Philly,
right?
A student and an instructor. An instructor of what?
Finance. I teach at Stanford and go to grad school there.
Wow.
And I promote music on the side.
Get back. Really? So
yeah.
So little edge here today, maybe?
Well, you know, the problem is that the people in the grad school never understand why I do music, and the people, you know, in the music business don't understand why I do grad school, so I don't think I'm particularly at any advantage.
Favorite
as you can see.
Yeah, well, true. All right. Well, it's nice to have you here anyway.
Thank you.
You should think about a little something right here in the tongue, maybe. Because it looks good.
We'll talk
about it. All right. Here's the deal. We're going to play Double Jeopardy. You know what happens here. Two daily doubles. Question's a little tougher. Easier to catch up. Anything else I can tell you? You want the categories?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. Let's check them out. Spin. Now, what's going to happen here is you're going to see covers from Spin magazine. Fashionable music, grunge groups, songs, R&B, and Celine Dion. Songs, of course, in quotes, means songs will, the word song will be in the response. All right, third place is Alex, so you begin this round.
I'd like R&B for 200, please.
It's an audio clue. In 1967, this R&B legend took the song heard here to number two.
I'm headed to your change, change,
change, change, change, change.
Randi. Who is Aretha Franklin?
Aretha Franklin is right.
I will take Spin for 200, please.
Video clue. It's the group seen here on a 1997 cover. Randi.
Who is Prodigy?
No.
Ooh.
Douglas.
Who is U2?
U2 is right.
Can I get Fashionable Music for 200, please?
Randi Newman's baby could take off her coat and shoes, among other things, but she had to leave this on. Randi.
What is her hat?
Her hat.
I'll take Fashionable Music for 400, please.
In 1982, Stevie Nicks and Don Henley combined forces and voices on Leather and This. Alex.
What is Lace?
Lace is right.
R&B for 400, please.
His African Queen and European Queen weren't as popular as his Caribbean Queen. Douglas.
Who is Billy Ocean?
Billy Ocean.
Can I get songs for 200, please?
Song in which he was strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words. Alex.
What is Killing Me Softly?
A little more.
What is Killing Me Softly with his song?
There you go.
R&B for 600?
In 1987, she found herself caught up in the rapture of love. Alex.
Who is Anita Baker?
Anita Baker.
R&B for 800?
It's a day double. Right. Taking a look at the board, Randi has a slight lead. You and Douglas are hanging in there. How much you want to wager?
2,000.
$2,000. Way to go. Here it is. In 1996, their Crazy Sexy Cool album was certified as the best-selling album ever by an all-female group.
Who is TLC?
Wow, didn't even hesitate. It's your board.
R&B for 1,000.
I want you to name this artist who had a hit with I Don't Ever Want to See You Again. Who is Uncle Sam? Ring any bells?
No.
No, me neither. Alex, it's you.
How about Celine Dion for 200?
Okay. Before 1990, Celine had 9 best-selling albums in this language. Douglas.
What is French?
Sure.
Can I Celine Dion for 400, please?
On the Carole King tribute album, Celine sang, you make me feel like one of these. Douglas.
Was a natural woman?
Right.
Can I get Celine Dion for 600, please?
Air Supply and Laura Branigan charted with this song, but Celine took it to number one. Alex.
What is The Power of Love?
Right.
Celine Dion for 800.
For I Hate You, Then I Love You, Celine joined up with this opera heavyweight. Randi.
Who is Pavarotti?
Correct.
I'll take Fashionable Music for 600, please.
British group who sang of a dedicated follower of fashion. Randi.
Who are the Rolling Stones?
Nope.
Oh.
Who are the Kinks? Randi, it's yours.
Okay, let's try Fashionable Music for 800, please.
ZZ Top sang about a cheap pair of these. Randi.
What are sunglasses?
Of course.
Fashionable Music for 1,000, please.
This Third Eye Blind song includes the line, those little red panties, they passed the test. What is Semi-Charmed Life? And boy, isn't there something fun about saying little red panties. I don't know.
Let's try this again. I'll take grunge groups for 200, please.
All right. This group came onto the scene in 1989 with Bleach and made their name with Nevermind. Randi.
Who is Nirvana?
Of course.
I will take grunge groups for 400, please.
This band sure goes through drummers, Dave Cruzan, Dave Abbruzzese, and Jack Irons. Douglas.
Who is Spinal Tap?
Nope. Randi or Alex? Who is Pearl Jam? Randi, it's still your board.
Grunge groups for 600, please.
When Scott Weiland was with this group, they had hits with Creep, Plush, and Vaseline. Randi.
Who is Stone Temple Pilots?
Yep.
I will take grunge groups for 800, please.
This group came out of a band Lane Staley formed in high school. What is Alice in Chains? Randi, still yours.
Okay, let's try songs for 400, please.
Tony Braxton tune that has me all torn up, be it fast or slow, it doesn't let go. Alex.
What is another sad love song?
Right.
Songs for 600.
It's a daily double. It's an audio daily double. You're doing very well. Very tight with Randi there. Douglas still hanging in there. What do you want to wager?
1500.
Okay. It's the title of the song Heard Here.
When I was young, it seemed that life was so wonderful. America, oh, it was
good. What is the logical song?
Right. Nice job. Bumps you up into the lead.
Songs for 800.
Okay. Cheers to Rupert Holmes, who sang this song about cocktails and getting caught in the rain. Alex.
What is the Pina Colada song?
Yeah.
Songs for 1,000.
Paul Simon must have been feeling groovy when he wrote this song, later a hit for Harper's Bazaar. Douglas.
What is 59th Street song?
No.
59th Street.
Alex.
What is the 59th Street Bridge song?
Right. Is that where you're going to go, Douglas?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Nice job. We have just less than a minute left, guys.
Celine Dion for 1,000.
Celine's Because You Love Me from this film was Oscar nominated. What is Up Close and Personal, Alex?
How about Spin for 400?
Okay. Artists seen here. As of June 1998, a web ring devoted to her had 82 sites. Randi.
Who is Fiona Apple?
No. Oh. Tough one. Douglas, Alex? Alanis Morissette. Ooh, really? Alex,
that's
yours.
Good.
How about spin for 600?
Oh my God! Characters from this animated series made the March 1998 cover. Alex.
What is South Park?
South Park, right.
Spin for 800?
This singer's been a bad, bad girl. Alex.
Who is Fiona Apple?
There she is. All right, that is the end of the second round, Double Jeopardy here. Let's take a look at the scores. Alex did very well, 10,900. Randi at 62 and Douglas at 2,500. You know what happens for the person who has the most points at the end of the game, right? We covered this?
Yeah.
What was it, Douglas?
$5,000.
$5,000. Second, third, need not worry because Loretta, need no protector, has got a big old bag full of prizes.
That is the truth, Jeff. For today's second place contestant, you and a guest will fly to Las Vegas, Nevada on Southwest Airlines Vacations, where you'll enjoy complete packages of fun. Pack your bags and you're on your way with Southwest Airlines Vacations. And you'll stay at the only 4-star Diamond Resort located in the heart of Fremont Street, the Golden Nugget, Las Vegas. For today's third place contestant, the Bose Wave Radio, the only tabletop radio to deliver rich, lifelike stereo sound in a small, convenient size. You have to hear the Wave Radio for yourself to believe it. Call 1-800-294-BOSE or see us online at www.bose.com. Feel the beat. All contestants today will receive a London Fog weather fleece jacket. Soft and comfortable, weather repellent, pill-free and washable. Ideal for layering. 20 vibrant colors for men and women. London Fog, weather or not. Back to you, Jeff.
All right, players, the final Rock and Roll Jeopardy category is... The Beatles. Give you a couple of minutes to make your wagers. Come right back on Rock and Roll Jeopardy. It's time for final Rock and Roll Jeopardy. The category is The Beatles. Players will have 30 seconds with this clue. At 15 weeks, it is The Beatles' album that spent the longest time in the number one spot in the U.S. Good luck. Douglas, currently in third place. What'd you have? What is Please Please Me? Sorry, that's not right. What'd you wager? 20, you just couldn't go the full route, could you? You had to keep 1 point left.
That's right.
All right, Randi. What was your response? There we go. Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. And your wager was? 6,100. Vaults you into the lead, temporarily anyway. Alex, you know what the right response is. Did you have it? You sure did. Did you wager enough? Well, I can't even do that math. Wow, just barely. You knew what you had to do, didn't you? You're a finance guy, of course. Sure, come on over. $5,000 for you guys. Head on over. That's all the time we have for Rock and Roll Jeopardy. Look for me on Access Hollywood. I'll see you here next time for more Rock and Roll Jeopardy. Guys, that was a lot of fun.
Come visit our website at www.rockjeopardy.com.